Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be painting the backs of both driver's side doors. In the last video, I actually repainted the front of the driver's side door, and I was going to show you, but then Final Cut decided to not render 15 minutes of the video. I was really tired. I edited it so I painted the doors, went home, edited the video, and started uploading at 1 in the morning. So I didn't really notice it, and then once people started commenting, I was like, watch the end of the video, I was like, oh, 15 minutes are missing. So what I'm gonna be doing is getting these doors painted. Tomorrow I'll flip that one over, paint the front side, and then we'll have all the doors finished. Then what I'm gonna be doing is getting the roof ready. So I'm gonna redo the mold, or not redo the mold, let's take a step back. I don't wanna redo the mold. So I'm gonna be making the final attempt at the roof. Hopefully we're successful. It is a lot warmer, so I think I'll be a lot more successful, and I have a lot more experience with this larger mold, and I know how to pretty much run the lines. I'm gonna pretty much run 2 safety lines just in case if it doesn't get too wet the whole thing out, I'll have them already in the bag. And then I'm also gonna use bag the whole mold, which will be really nice. So let's get these doors painted. I'm not gonna really video it because I've painted a lot of doors. I think people know what it looks like when I paint doors. So we'll just go with the snap method. So let's go. So now I have the back of both doors painted, and what I'm gonna do tomorrow is actually get this door ready, paint the front of it, and then I'm gonna take this door out and store it in the shipping container. It's just really relieving that I'm almost finished painting the doors. I know a lot of people, this project is taking a long time. It is a big project. It takes a lot of work to paint stuff. So I'm gonna get this stuff done. Tomorrow I'm also gonna seal the body of the car finally, and then I could get to work on getting the interior all cleaned up. I'll probably clean the interior up first. The last door is finally painted. I also pulled the hinges off and painted them, but I forgot to paint the bolts over here. So I will be painting those when I paint the mirrors, and maybe when I paint the car, because I need to paint some of that stuff. So I'm just happy that the doors are finished. So now we have all 4 doors finished, and really what's left now is to get the car ready. So what I'm gonna start doing now is actually sanding the door jams, getting everything ready so I can seal the car. It's so relieving that I'm getting to the point where I'm gonna seal the car and all the doors are off of it. I mean, it's just been a really long road, but we're getting there. So let's clear all this stuff out and then get, actually I'll clear this stuff out in a little bit. I'm gonna start sanding on the doors because this is still a little bit tacky. Man, it's really windy. Look, these things are shaking. The outside of the car is ready to get in sealer. Everything is sanded in 320 grit. What I'm gonna do now is actually vacuum out. I brought my shop vac over. I'm gonna vacuum out all that sound deadening and then scuff the whole inside of the car and clean it up as good as I can. Body is now ready to be sealed. So I just finished blowing the car out, then vacuuming it, just to get all the dust and body filler and all the dust from primer dust, all that stuff gets all in the nooks and crevices. I probably haven't even got all of it out of there, but I have enough out of there to mask this thing off, and then I can hit it with sealer, and then I can go from there. So once I'm done with the sealer, I'll let it bake in the sun for a day or so. Then while it's baking in the sun, I'm going to coat the inside of the car with the undercoating and heat barrier. So that'll look all brand new inside. And then once that's done, which that'll lock in whatever residual dust is left. I'm still gonna wipe everything down, but there is a lot of nooks and crevices and all that stuff. So it'll really help lock in all that whatever's left over, and then I'll wet sand the outside of the car. Also, by sealing the outside of the car first, that is water-based, so if I do get any of it on the sealer, I won't have to worry about wiping it off. I really don't want to get it on the high build primer. So let's get to work. First off, I'm going to seam seal the rest of the stuff that I need to seam seal, because now it's all cleaned up and we can just kind of go from there. I need to seam seal this inner wheel lip as well. So I'm going to get all that stuff nice and done before I get this thing sealed on the outside, and then we can just really, it's getting close, really, really close to being painted. So can't wait to see this thing in color, but I don't want to rush it. So I'm going to take my time on the final stages. On the paint booth, everything is ready to go. What I need to do is hit this with some wax and grease and then hit it with some sealer. But I ended up getting all the seam sealer done. Wherever there's sound deadening, there wasn't a seam sealer, so I applied it in the necessary spots just so we wouldn't get any leaks, even though I'm gonna have that pretty much bed liner in here, which will 100% seal it from there. I also sealed around the transfer case tunnel that I made, and it's kind of weird because there was different colors, but they're both supposed to be gray. But yeah, all that stuff's good to go. So what I'm really gonna focus on sealing, I still need to mask off the engine bay so I don't get any sealer on that, but I'm really just gonna seal these rails. I'm not even gonna worry about this right here. I'll probably seal up in the door frame part, but I'm not gonna worry about down here. Maybe down here a little bit, but not too much. And then the quarter panel. So there isn't too much to seal. I also put seam sealer where it's supposed to go on that edge. And I think that looks pretty good. It'll look good once it's painted. But let's get this thing cleaned. Let's get it sealed. has been a long time coming, and I'm very excited to finally have the car out of primer and finally in sealer. And it just is really relieving when you see that reflection in the sealer and all the quarter panels and everything is nice and smooth. I'm 100% sure that all I'll have to do is 600 grit this and glue the roof on. So in the next couple episodes, I'm gonna be remaking the carbon fiber roof. I really think I'm gonna be successful at this next attempt because I'm gonna pretty much, I've learned from all my other experiences, the resin that I'm using is a lot thinner, and I'm also gonna have a safety net. So plus bagging the whole mold is gonna go a lot quicker. So tomorrow morning, I'm gonna put the gel coat in the mold. By the end of the night, I'm hoping to have the roof finished finally. Once the roof's done, glue it on the car, and then we can get the car painted. So I'm going to actually sand the roof and then mask it off. Then I could clear everything once the car is painted, so it just has that really nice, deep, super glossy shine. So I'm gonna end the video here. If you like these videos, make sure to click the subscribe button, throw a thumbs up, throw a comment below. I know it's been a long process, but we're finally getting somewhere with all this body work and everything, and we'll be assembling this thing once it's painted. And I'm very excited to see this all with the wide body stuff. Can't wait. But see you guys till next time.